Allora, buon giorno, continuing with physics, and we are going to talk about electric field. We have particles, they have affected of a force and we have a particle example. We have a particle plus particle with Q equals to 10 plus 2 micro coulombs, and it is affecting the another particle in distance on equals to centimeters, and this is Q here and this is F here. Then we know that F equals to EQ, but F is KQ1 divided by R over by 2. Then this Q and this Q, and we are going to have E equal to K U1 R divided by 2, 9 multiplied by 10 over by 9 multiplied by 3.2 multiplied by 10 power by minus 6 and 22 power by 2 is almost 720 kilonewtons each color. Example is that in a place we have a particle P and we have two charges, Q1, Q2 is minus 50 to minus Coulomb, which is plus 88 nano Coulomb. And they are in a place of 12 centimeters from each other. And we want to know And this one is alpha 1, and this one is alpha 2. And X1 is K, Q1, Q2 divided by R, divided by 2. In P, and we calculate this one, 88 10 by 9, and 0 10 by 2, and it is almost 157 micro Newton, and alpha 1 equals to R tangent 3 divided by secant, and alpha 2 is R tan 3 by 5. And it is in the example, it is given those values. And S2 is K, QP, Q2, RP, 2 power by 2. And it is enough to be fun. It is there. Now S equals to F1 2 plus F2 2 minus 2 F1 F2 equals to alpha 1 minus alpha 2, which is translated this we have done. We have calculated it is that something, this is that diagram. We have the diagram or a picture or a photo, and the first we do, we put a charge, one nanocloud on point P, and then we calculate alpha 1, alpha 2, and we calculate the distances. The distances is this distance and this distance, which gives this distance, and this distance and this distance is that distance. And we calculate the angle between each part, and then we use the force function over two charges, and then we are going to, and we have a dash force, and we have a dash force, and we are going to have a that resulting force on each part. This force, and this force, and the resulting is that force. Okay. Now we are going to charges Q1 equals to 4 × 3/10 minus 6 coulomb, and Q2 equals to 9 × 3/10 minus 6 coulomb. And we will know if there is and the distance is between them is 0.5 meters. Now we are asking if there is a point that the force is zero, which means that when the F1 minus F2 equals to zero, then Q1 divided by R12 equals to Q2 R22. Then Q1 divided by Q2 equals to R1 divided by R2 followed by 2. But R2 is R1 R1 R minus R1 followed by 2. R1 equals to square Q1 divided by Q2 R divided by 1 plus Q1 divided by Q2, which is 4 divided by 9, 1 plus 4 divided by 9, which is 2 divided by 3 plus 1 plus 2 divided by 3, which is 1 divided by multiplied by 3 divided by 5, which is all times 6 meters. No, it is not 2. This 1 divided by 0.2 meters from particle 1. From Q1 and 0.4 minus 0.2 is 0.3. We know that the Earth is a sphere, each in a sphere with equals to 120 newtons as follows, and its radius, the Earth radius, 6,370 kilometers. Then we can think that the Earth corner is a very charged the address, and we want to know the charge. And the charge is the earth. The charge is a particle on the earth surface. It's K to Q1 divided by R over by 2, which is Q1. Then Q is E on 2 divided by K. Then it is 120 minus 7, 6.37 minus 7 over by 6 over by 2 divided by 9 minus 7. 10 over by 9. And the result is 540 kilo corner. Going to talk about the potential energy. The potential energy, we have a mass, and we have a gravitational potential, the G, and double the P. Potential energy is Mg. And you have a right here, and this is this. Okay. And in electric potential energy, the electricity, it is Vq. V is the potential of is the electric potential, and the electric potential, and it is in volt. Have a body with mass 3 kilograms, and it falls free fall from a height, and we have a gravitation potential. This is a 60 joule per kilogram. And what Vg S and Vg 2 is 20 kilogram, and we want to know what is the W level. The first we find it here, WP equals to 3 multiplied by 60, which is 180 U. And in this level, the G equals to Vg1 minus Vg2, this is 40 joule per kilogram, then W is equals to the motion energy equals to 40 multiplied by 60 or 6 is 120. And also find the energy in this level and minus this one is going to you can find the potential energy WP2 1 2 equals to 3 multiplied by 20, which is 60 joules, and W motion is these two difference of these two, and it is 180 minus 50, which is 120 joules. What is the velocity a proton with a what is the velocity v equals what when the w motion equals to 150 electron volts in electric field, and we call it WK kinetic kinetic energy or motion energy. Electron volt is 150 1.6 multiplied by 10 power by minus 19 joules, which is 2.4 multiplied by 10 power by minus 17 joules. And the proton's mass of proton is 1.67 multiplied by 10 minus 27 kilograms, and those values you can find in tables, in a standard tables. And WK equals to mv2 divided by 2, then V equals to square 2 WK divided by M, which is a square 2 multiplied by this one, 2.4 multiplied by minus 17 divided by 1.67 multiplied by 10 power by minus 270, and it is 1.5 multiplied by 10 power by 5 meters each second, not example in these is that we have two plates, and the potential between them is U, and we have a point A, and we have a point D. Distance between those two plates is D, and we have a electric strength, and we have a particle Q here, this plus, and we want to know the work WAB equals to UAB multiplied by Q. It is work, and it is the voltage between A and B, and multiplied by Q, and E equals to U divided by V, which is still the strength, and it is the voltage divided by distance. We have an example for V. Find themselves in the D distance of 12 millimeter and U is 3.5 kilovolt. What is the force on an electron in the in that field? We know that F is EQ and E is U divided by D cube, and electron has a U is 3.5 multiplied by 10 power by 3 divided by 0.012 multiplied by 1.6 multiplied by 10 power by minus 19. Then F equals to this calculation is 15 newton. Okay, it was all in this chapter. See you on next tutorial. Just a second, I must see if I can find another example. Very quick. Very quick example. Another example. What is the W motion? Equals to how much? 130 volts to V2 minus 15 volts. You know that WP1 plus WM1 equals to WP2 plus WM2. Then delta WM equals to delta WP, which is V1Q minus V2Q, which is V1 is 130 minus 15 multiplied by 24 multiplied by 10 minus 9. Then delta WM equals to 315 nanojoules. Okay, it was all. It was all in this video. See you in next video, which is about the capacitance. We are going to talk about the capacitance and maybe induction or maybe the circuit. Okay, see you on next video.